what are the differences between REPRI now and the New Deal TOP? I have no loyalty to either one. It's a matter of what does the best job and what's, of course, the cost. And REPRI started pretty expensive. It was $50 a month, and I said, and I got it down to 30, and now apparently they're looking at 20. Because, of course, Deal TOP is there and offering them some formidable competition. So the deal is, and where it starts to be different, is that REPRI and Deal TOP are industry specific. You could pull any document into it and digitally sign as you do with DocuSign, but your beginning, whoops, lost my mouse now. Okay, if I go to REPRI.com, I'll log in here. Hopefully I've done this on this machine. I mentioned this to Zan, I really didn't realize I was doing this today, but okay. Open up.
So what did Andrew have to say between Deal TOP and REPRI?
What's that? Well, he showed me a couple of things, but because you've got crowds around and everything else, he said, listen, we'll do a one-on-one, and literally I'll show you all the differences.
So is Andrew Mr. Deal TOP?
He's Mr. Deal TOP,
okay.
And Sandra Kirkland is Mrs.
REPRI,
okay, in Ontario. So what we have is a program that's designed for real estate, and as such, in both cases now, Deal TOP didn't have this, but now they do, all of the forms that we use are preloaded into the platform. So it's not just a, okay, I create this document and any document, pull it into the platform, tag it, send it out, sign it, and then go print it or send it as a PDF. Now, REPRI, you can actually put your entire database if you want, and I believe Deal TOP is exactly the same. If you wanted, you could load all your contacts in and run it almost as a CRM. And when you have a deal with Fred and Wilma Flintstone or whatever, you pull them in, you say, I need a new transaction, it's going to be a purchase, and then you open up the documents, and I need the agreement of purchase and sale, I need the confirmation of representation, I need the FinTrack forms and everything else.
So it's like a web forms with the ability to email.
It's exactly like a web forms, even to the point that when web forms gets updated, so do they.
Okay.
If web forms is down, and it does happen from time to time, not that often, there's nothing, I've loved web forms ever since they created it, but if web forms is down, and it happened a few weeks ago, somebody in one of my Facebook groups posted, web forms is down, I need an amendment, what am I going to do, or a waiver. I said, well, send it to me, send me the details, and what I did is I went into my REPRI, because it doesn't rely on web forms, I did it for them, and I sent them the electronic PDF so that they could then go and print it or do whatever, and they could draw it into DocuSign or anything else. What it is it's got the components that make it much easier to work it. And that's really why, oh, no internet connection here. Just a second, I was using my phone. Hopefully we got enough juice here.
We have Wi-Fi.
Can you put the wireless on?
I don't know what to do with
Wi-Fi. So really what we're looking at, as I say, is okay, here's DocuSign, and it's great, and it's wonderful, but it's for everybody. You're going to create a form in web forms. You're then going to pull it into DocuSign and do everything. And then you're going to ship it wherever.
But where's the wireless?
Down here, down where it has that little flash there, yeah. Different though, in REPRI and Deal TOP, yeah, Ed?
Does it have an app, REPRI?
It has a mobile site. I don't know if it's specifically an app. I will tell you.
This is the issue with mobility, is that other, if it doesn't have an app, it's not going to work on a tablet.
Oh, no, it does.
Oh, it does fully.
Yeah.
Like literally, I had people in Mexico that had nothing but their iPhone.
To sign it, but I mean to fill in the forms without an app. I noticed in DocuSign and AuthentiSign, when you bring it into the app, bring it into your tablet, it brings it in the browser, and if it's in a browser, you can't read it. It's so small to try and fill it in. If you're sending it to someone, they don't see all of the detail work that you have. So it's very hard with anyone of these that don't have an app built. It'll work perfectly on your computer, your laptop, as long as you're carrying a laptop. I don't. I only do everything mobile, even filling in the app. I'm filling in a listing tomorrow morning with a client. We'll assign it right there. But I couldn't do that with Repre, I don't believe.
I can do it on my iPad quite easily, but I'll check. I'll talk to Sandra and I'll talk to
Andrew. Just the size of the screen is hard to work, very hard to work on.
But I know that they saw and read everything that they said yes to.
Oh yeah, that's okay.
And it really takes them step by step. So you go in and tag, and you tag yourself as a, you know, a signer, because you're going to sign certain parts. And you can have as many signers as you want. And then you then tag the document just the same as you would. Now apparently DealTap, and this is one of the advances that they've made, if you pull up a buyer agency form, they've already smart thought it to say, okay, this is a buyer agency form. The buyer's going to have to sign here, initial here, initial here, initial here, and sign here, and it does it for you automatically. That's one of the steps that DealTap has taken over Repre. Now is Repre obviously going to try and jump on that? I'm sure they are. Okay, so there are some differences, and that's what I want to find out. I do know you can have your contacts in, do whatever you want, and then go through the process. As I say, I had a deal in my people were in Mexico, and they did it right from their iPhone. Yes, I agree to that. Yes, I agree to that. Yes, I agree to that. Yes, I sign here. Yes, I do this. Save it, and as soon as it's saved, the documents are delivered to everybody that's a signer. When it's done, everybody has a copy automatically. So there's some really cool things about it. The cool thing is that they both offer a free trial period anyway. So you can go in and play with both. I'll have more experience. Once I've talked to Andrew, I'm going to play with their system. And then I'll know, you know, which way to go on. Yeah, log on. Good. I'm glad I'd already logged on here because I probably wouldn't remember my password. And here's my account with the different things that have come up. Come on, you can do it. There. So here's my account. And these are the deals that I've done in here and a couple of others, obviously, that weren't done in here. So you can add a person. So add a contact, add client. So if I go in here and add Zan, Molko, and then I need his email because eventually it's going to go to him, zan@zanmolko.com. And that's all I actually need. I can fill out the rest if I want. If he was already in my contacts, it would just carry all automatically over. Okay. But I'm entering him as a new contact. Okay. Add another contact. If Zan and his wife Carol Molko are buying from me, then I can add her as a contact as well in a separate email address. So I'll put Carol@zanmolko.com. Whether she has it or not.
Yeah,
she
exactly.
.com. And I save that. Okay, so that's done. Save all contact information. So now we're over here. Somewhere, there's Zan. So, add a transaction. I go and say, okay, so I'm going to add, Zan's going to buy my house today. He didn't know that, but I didn't know I was doing this either, so fair is fair. And this is, he's going to be the buyer. It's an active listing. I guess I should probably capitalize this because it's going to carry over onto the document. But. Crescent.
No,
no, did two. There we go. As you see, I'm not used to 20 people looking over my shoulder. So now we have this. That's our transaction. And we want to add forms. So we click on this. Add forms. Okay, close that. Here's all my forms. Exactly like in web forms, and you can do all the searches, search for a form, do whatever. I'm just going to add the agreement of purchase and sale. And I'm going to add the confirmation. Let's see. And
So we know every form that would be on a RIA or in web form is on here too.
And it's updated at the same time.
Okay.
So you don't need to wait for updates like Easy Offer or something, yes.
What about your clauses? Because then with web forms, you can build a template, right? So what do you do with all your clauses?
Oh, the clauses has a section in here for everything. When we get there, you'll see add clauses. All the regular clauses are there. You can load your special clauses if you have your own personal clauses. It's all, it's essentially a web forms built into the program. So does anybody know what the confirmation number is? Okay.
300 or 320, one or the other, sorry.
Three.
I'll forget which one's which. Confirmation. 300 and then 320.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. So there, now I have my forms. Populate them. Okay, now it says, okay, what address are you looking for? 1746 Broad Oak Crescent. Well, what it's actually going to do, oops, silly of me. I'm relatively new with it, but the street name, Broad Oak. I guess I shouldn't have had it on populate. That was a mistake. Okay. Crescent. Yeah. Done that. Oh well, live and learn, Pickering, Ontario, da 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 da. Search for the property. It actually goes into the MPAC, into Geo Warehouse, and it pulls up the property as it's registered. And then it will load the property. The property's in my wife's name.
And legal description.
And it gives you the legal description and anything else, and it automatically loads my information in because it knows who I am. Okay? So then you go and you can either fill it in this way, or if you prefer seeing the actual form, you can go here and you can load it this way. So dated on this day of whatever, you can do it either way. We'll go to the form and fill in the form. So date agreement is today. I'm not going to make this long.
It's Friday
the 13th. David is not getting home tonight because there will be.
I headed the opposite direction. Yep. All the motorcycles.
Yeah, yeah. So we're on the east side. Legal description, purchase price. Zan, I'm not selling for less than $800, so buddy. Yeah, you pay me $800, you can have my house. Okay. Purchase price written.
Today's the day.
I had one of those people ask, hey, gee, if you were to sell your house, what would it take? It's $1 million, but it's only worth $750 somewhere. But you just go through and you fill it in, make check payable to, and blah, blah, blah. And then just, this is just, as I say, just like web forms. I'm not going to teach you anything here. Chattels included. Fixtures included, HST included, title search, and you put in all the signature dates and everything else, who the listing brokerage is, who the cooperating brokerage is. Well, in this case, I'm going in as the cooperating brokerage. So buyer's names, need to edit that a little bit. Clauses and phrases, you click on that. Here's all your clauses and phrases. You can search them, you can do whatever, just like you did for the others. So you can add some clauses. So let's go into deposits and payment, balance of the purchase price.
Does it have templates?
What's that?
Does it have templates with the clause?
Yeah, you can. You can build templates in it. I haven't done it yet, but and clauses and phrases will make it conditional on financing, and then we'll wrap it up.
There's a difference here. This looks like you're doing this in the free.
Mortgages. Seller take back, conditional sale, mortgage discharge, arranging new for first mortgage. So it's your thing. Okay, good enough. That's all we need for that.
Being connected.
And then once you've got that, you go over into the preview, have a look at it. Gee, this looks familiar. When we get down to the bottom of it, we save it, or save PDF to transaction.
So you effectively don't use web forms anymore.
I don't use web forms at all anymore.
Right here. That's just, yeah.
Okay. So there's my transaction. Now I want to take both of these documents.
But you're dealing with friends.
And I want to save it, and it's going to process it, and then I can take it and do all the tagging. Now this is where DealTap automatically goes, oh, you're a purchase agreement or purchase sale. You should be initialing and signing here.
Okay.
That's their new thing.
Does it also save it as an active file somewhere?
Yeah, you can save it as an editable file and as a PDF at this point, and it's keeping all those documents, like every version is being kept, but at the same time, it's also tracking where every single thing is created, signed, it gives you a geolocator, so within 30 feet of where you're signing, and date stamps to the second.
No, I mean, like as in web forms, what do you save, that you could save it as a kit? So you want to go back and copy and paste your...
You can do that, I haven't learned that yet.
Probably on the ad transaction, it'll say.
Okay, so if I want to ratify, here are my forms, okay, they're done, and here's the editable version, so if I want to make different changes, okay, but these have been saved, so I go into my ratify. Here, I'm going to add myself as a signer. I'm going to be a signer. I can do it as an in-person signer and do it right here rather than have it emailed to me and open up. So if I'm sitting with a client in a client room and I'm doing it on my iPad, when I get to them and if they're an in-person signer, it's going to come up and say, "You're done, now hand the tablet to the next person." You can then decide, and I'm just going to stay as a signer, if you want to assign a password to it, you can. So if I've got like my mom and dad share email accounts, okay? If they were getting a divorce, I might not want my dad to have signature and be able to sign for my mom as well, going into the same account. So I could then assign a password to him and a password to her and say, when you open it up, your password's 1234, when you open it up, it's, and then not let them know each other. So I've not done that, but you can.
Yeah, so it is possible to send to two people at the same email account?
Yeah, you can, okay. But if you were, you might want to put a password on it.
Okay? I have DocuSign, you can't do that.
Okay, you can do it here.
Just don't email them the password.
Well, no,
you can send
it. You would text them, call them, whatever. Okay,
really? Oh, yeah.
So here's Zan.
I do it all the time.
He is going to, and you can actually route who's going to assign in what order. So if I want to sign first, and then, or you can make them all ones, which means whoever gets there first signs and does whatever. It doesn't matter. And then I'm going to add Carol. So Carol's going to be really weirded out because she gets digital documents and she didn't know she was buying my house today. You might want to let her know.
She's going to be on my case. She's quite happy to sell our house.
And I'm not really happy to sell mine, so maybe I should up that price. Anyway, so here we are. We've got, and this is what your client's going to get. You can edit this all you want. Documents for electronic signing for the address. And then when they get that and they click on it, which I'll send it to myself and you'll see it. So I want to take this document and I want to take this document over here. Because I'm going to sign them, and then it says tag documents for signatures. You go in here, it pulls up the documents, and you'll see at the top of the form, there's all three of us, because we're all three signers, are showing. Drum roll.
You get one.
Good. Rick, what's the cost per month?
What's that?
What's the cost per month?
Cost at this rate now is 30, but I hear that cost is coming down because I think DealTap is like 17 a month if you buy a year, and it's like 20 or 25 a month if you buy it month by month.
So I've been using Dotloop, which is both Keller Williams back end.
Yes.
From what I've seen so far, this seems a lot more user-friendly.
I've heard that, but I haven't used Dotloop.
I've only done two or three transactions for the Dotloop, so I'm still learning it.
Cindy, did you have a question?
Yeah, I'm sorry. If this is industry specific to real estate, can you pull in other documents?
Yes.
Where
I had the documents there, there's a tag up on top. Right now I'm in the tagging to do these. You can add document, and you just load in a PDF, and it would show up here exactly the same way.
Thank you.
So one of the things, and I don't know what DealTap does with it, but one of the advantages you have with Recreate, they give you unlimited storage. You can actually load your surveys, your floor plans, your pictures, your everything into one file and keep that, and they don't charge you for it. So anyway, so here's my representation, and I'm going to start, and I might as well start with me because I'm there first, and I'm going to initial. So I drag my initial. I'm going to initial. I'm the cooperating broker in this case because, and then I'm going to sign down, and you can do this, okay, I can turn over and say, okay, Carol's going to initial as well over here, and Zan's going to initial, or I can drag you both because you're both going to do it, so let's do that next time. So initials there, and you see each color matches the thing there, and then I'm going to sign. down here. So I just drag this down. Come on, come with me.
Can I interject? I just got a response earlier, just found it from Blue Mountain. I beat them up on the price. They've gone down to $129 a night.
Yeah.
Let's just do it.
But I'll give it a go ahead. They've made some modifications to the way the food's calculated, but I don't think it's out of line. It may be a little bit more than last year, just because they're doing it a la carte. And in theory, it's probably within $10.
No extra charge for the outhouses.
So is that okay? By acclamation, we're going. Sorry, Mark.
Do it.
Yep.
Look
forward to November.
It's okay, but you don't have to host the barbecue again. Tell John is off the. But by the way, the wine is amazing. You guys, Lee and I finally got wine from John, and we're ready to put the second order in. At least I am.
Okay, so we're ready to go with
wonderful.
Yeah. Okay, so we're good to go with that.
So up here we have text, we have time and date stamps if you want to. You can move everything around, but if it drops where you don't want it to, you just pick it up and move it around. I don't know why I just did that. Don't do that. Thank you. So I want to put.
Oh, not again.
Yeah. No, I know. There. So I can date timestamp anything. The other thing that this program does, though, that doesn't happen in DocuSign, that I'm aware of, I shouldn't speak too online, is that you have the ability to make changes directly on the document. So if I change the price and I've said, you know what, sorry, Zan, I'm not selling for $800. I'm going to sell for $9 because I'm greedy. Oops, sorry. I don't need it to be. I had your boxes clipped there. Let's just get rid of that here. Drag this back up. Come on. Work, magic mouse, work. Okay, it's not cooperating. Anyway, I can edit and do. This should drag back up to disappear. Now here, we'll just wipe it. There. So if I want to do a strike through, I can bring down the strike through box. And I can make this as long as I want it to be. So you don't have to go on text field XXX. And then I can bring down a text field here. And then I can type in 900,000. I'm getting greedy, just like every other seller in the world. Okay, so 900,000, and it's done. Okay? So it's just other things that you can do within the program.
I think, but then you have to initial that price.
Yeah, exactly. So you would go over here and say, okay, I need Zan and Carol. In fact, all of us need to initial this, so I'm just going to take the initial box. I'm going to put it over here. It's going to show up all three. I can move them around as I want.
Okay.
So that's done. And then you can, as I say, so you can literally edit everything right in here. You don't have to do it by hand. And then just pull out through anything that you're initialing. Okay, Zan and Carol are initialing down here. Initial here. And you just go through the whole document. When you finish, what's going to happen, they're going to sign here. So we'll take Zan down here. I won't make any of your comments. Carol. Text field doesn't want that. Anyway, we're running out of time. Suffice to say that once I've done all the documents, all I need to do is send it. Okay, and then it's going to process it. I now, if I go into my email, I will have electronic signatures for doing it, and I'll just show you that quickly. And then as soon as I'm done, it's going to go to Zan and to Carol.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I might want to not finish that. And then, as I say, with my clients down in Mexico, they did not have a computer. All they had was their iPhone, and they literally went, yep, yep, and it tells them as you go through. So it says, start signing session. First thing it's going to say is, are you willing to do this electronically? You have to say yes. If not, you decline it. It will automatically go to print form. If they say, no, I'm not comfortable with this, it'll automatically say, okay, do you want to print it off? And then you can do it manually. I say, yes, I agree. Start electronic signing. You have a choice. You can either draw your signature, and it's really messy, or you can pick to use a font, and then you can pick different fonts. Okay, I pick this. That's the one I usually use. Save signature and initials. saving, okay, now it's ready to go, so start signing. It tells me I have three tags that I've got to sign or initial, and it's telling me, so yes, click on the initial to remove it. No, I want to go next. Yes, signing here. Next. Yep, next. That's just telling me that the date tagged and stamped it. Here I've got an initial. They wanted me to see that, so yeah, I initialed that. So now I can finalize the document. Save signed document. The second I save that, it's gone to Zan and it's gone to Carol. So let your wife know she's buying my house, okay? Right now, it just went into the email. When Zan gets it, he can do it on his phone. He can go, yep, 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 yep. The second he gets done, it's with Carol. Once Carol finishes, I should have just made you're not assigning. Sorry.
Next to those things, just bought a house.
Yeah. So what happens is from there, once the last person saves the document, everybody gets an email of the finalized document in a PDF in their email automatically. So all the electronic signatures are done. And then you can pull it, as I say, and if you've got the REPRE, if you make changes, you can do it all in here. And literally not print a single piece of paper ever.
Beautiful. Yeah,
and this loads, this is completely compatible with Lone Wolf loading docks, which is what all the brokerages are going to. So literally, I can send that digital file in a PDF directly into the loading docks.
You bought it.
And what happens is, then all of those categories fill into the proper spaces on your admin. So suddenly they've got the buyer's names, the seller's names, the lawyers, the dates, the whole deal, all in one package, automatically loaded into their system if they've got loading docks.
Yeah.
It's pretty simple.
As soon as Dan does this,
Carol has to do it.
But you're not notified when he's finished. You're only notified at the end.
I'm notified at the end. It may tell me. I don't remember. But as I say, if it were just the two, literally, I could have had Zan come here and had an in-person signer, and he could have done it right on my laptop or on my tablet. So that's the difference. Is DocuSign is like app. Yes, it's a great program. You have to modify it to do it in to be using it in real estate. I used to run on it, I loved it, but my wife literally had to go through and set up categories and columns and everything else, so eventually we just went to a real estate driven program. This is a real estate driven program, it's for real estate.
Yeah. If I may though, it depends on your workflow. I use DocuSign and I didn't have to change any setup at all, because I use web forms and I save my kit.
Yeah.
As a PDF, but then I just pull the PDF into DocuSign and just execute the signatures exactly the same way.
Well, that's to do it that way.
It's a different workflow. It's just how you're using it, right?
The way he's saying it is
the same.
What happened a week ago Monday was that my people were in Mexico. The agent sent